bin location. So can you create a new folder where we will keep all our not here,
Okay.
separately in some place in your desktop or somewhere else.
Desktop.
Anywhere it is fine, but here you cannot save any file as it is any place. Not from here also. If you do it from outside, that will be better. I will tell you to means how you can change directories. So go inside that folder that you have created. Copy this path. Complete path. And go into your MATLAB and paste the same path in here on top. Enter. Okay. So this is how you will be changing the working directory. Now,
Okay.
problem is like every time you need to change working directory when you are logging in, right? So that is an issue. So can you go to your desktop? I just want to see like whether MATLAB icon is there or not. So when you click on, right click on that icon. Go to properties. Here, start in is there, right? There you paste the path that you have copied just now. Now apply and okay. And close your MATLAB and reopen it again. With the help of that icon, maybe. So now it is starting from where you wanted it. Okay. Now every time it will not go into the bin folder, and then it will create any, so you cannot save any files. So now coming to the MATLAB data type, we will see first. Okay. 1 minute. Okay, MATLAB data type. Okay. So in MATLAB, basically, it is not like C that you have some basic data types. It is already there, but you will not have this C type of data structure. Basically, you will have like higher class of data structure, like numeric data structure. Which could be either an integer or a float or anything relevant in a numerical format. Then coming to the next one, it is a character format. I will tell you how to check what are the formats and all those things in MATLAB. Okay. And there is a time date data type also, and categorical data type like arrays, tables also are there. But basically, we usually deal more on structures and cell array, function handles, these type of data type. These are different data type. So suppose, as we already have discussed on the screen, we have the command window when we try to execute any simple line. Then in that case, we will just write the line and press enter. Okay. Can you type x is equal to 1 or 10, semicolon, enter? Enter. So now your variable got created, okay, which is having the name X. Now if you type class in small letters, yeah, class bracket open, bracket close, in between X, yeah, capital X, otherwise it will show error. Enter. Okay, so it is saying a double type of data type. Yeah. So this is how you can usually be able to know the data type. If you type class, then you will be having the string which represents what is the type of the data that is there. You can type whose, HOS, WHOS. Yeah. Enter. Okay, yeah, if you type whose, then yeah, it will show every data that is being currently present in your workspace, what is the size, which data it is representing, what is the name, what is the actual memory byte that is being used, what is the class, and some attributes if it is added to that.
Okay.
Yeah, so, and if you type WHO, then it will just show you the variables. Yeah, can you type WHO? Yeah. What are the variables that are present? Suppose you have a long list of variables, then in that case it will be helpful.
Okay.
Yeah. And yeah, coming to the okay, now if you type HOME, home, there are some specific commands which are related to the command window. Yeah, if you scroll up, then whatever the variables or the output of the echo of the, yeah, it will be there. Suppose if you type CLC, can you type CLC? Yeah, enter. It will clear the command window completely. Okay, yeah, if you type clear all, yeah, clear all, then it will clear all the variables that are present here. Yeah, so like that it works. And yeah, suppose I want to change a directory also, some basic commands for this one, then I can use cd and the directory name where I want to change the location to. So yeah, those things we will see in the file operations. And yeah, so yeah, this is okay. Can you type x is equal to 10 again? Maybe, yeah, now you type it using the upper arrow key. Just press backspace, yeah, all you remove, and press upper arrow key. Yeah, upper arrow key you have pressed. No, no, upper arrow key means the navigation one. Yeah, so you will have all commands. As you can see, x is equal to 10 is there. If you click there, it will be typed directly. Yeah, if you click on the x is equal to 10, yeah, it will clip. Yeah, so there is also an option like you can press control and copy commands also. If you press upper arrow key again, then it will not show the remaining. Yeah. So yeah, if you press control and click on the commands, yeah, you will be able to select those. And then you can press control C and paste it somewhere in the script. Suppose you did some trial error, and then you are going to create a natural script that will run what are the executions that you have trialed in the process. Like suppose you have created a variable, you have manipulated it, then after that you have done some calculations, then you have some results that you have done in trial errors, whether it is working or not, whether it is working or not. At the end you will have a clear idea like these commands will work, you can copy those command and paste it into a script. And when you press on the run button, then the script will run fine without any error. Yeah, like that. Yeah, it is. And yeah, coming to the structure and cell type of data type, if you type when you type x is when you type one, only you type one and enter. As you are able to see now, there is a variable automatically gets created. Okay, so by default, when you will call a function without assigning it to anything, then it will store it in the ANS variable. ANS means answer, and it will store what is the current answer for the line. Suppose if you type 2 and press enter. Yeah, ANS got updated, right? By default, yes. It assigns to the ANS. So usually we try to prevent the use of the ANS, and that's why we use specific variables to test things.
Okay.
Yeah, just to avoid it will be overwritten.
Okay.